Hi, it's Heidi Hattendorf here with Automation Anywhere. I lead our global telecom practice for industry, and I'm really thrilled to be here today with Julen Mohanty from Prodapt. Prodapt is one of our strategic partners. Julen, thanks so much for joining.
It's all a pleasure.
So tell us a little bit, I know that you're 100% telecom and it's just been great to work with you, but tell us a little bit more about what Prodapt does and your approach to the market.
So Prodapt is into industry for almost 20 years. We have been quite big exposure into the OSS and the BSS side. We're mostly in the services sector, which we're doing for quite a lot of almost pretty big long time. Mm-hmm. We have been into the BPO services for almost 7 years, and we are doing quite a lot of stuff on the RPA for the last couple of years. If I can count, it's almost 3 years. We have got big of the telecom sectors in our belt as clients, and we have done exceptionally good job in not only RPA, but also intelligent automation. Mm. We have looked quite a lot of into analytics. We have done the machine learning and artificial intelligence, and that's where we are heading quite a lot now.
And when you look at telecom specifically and the intersection of that with intelligent process automation and with RPA, what do you see as some of the top use cases and where you've had the most traction?
So there are varieties of use cases. For example, with few of the telecom clients who are working on the business side of it, for example, you're looking in the financial reconciliation accounting side, some of the places which, again, one of the major area, we look into the order entry. It's coming from a customer entry to getting it the order dispatched and making sure that the lines are active and stuff. So that's what we do. So these are the major areas that we see. Not only that, the back office operations, so making sure that the bots are working to make sure that your book of records are same, making sure the customer doesn't have a fallout because of non-payments and stuff, making sure that your accounting books are based on the uses of the customer and stuff. So those kind of things we are doing in a big way.
Yeah, that's great. And I know you've had a lot of success and traction there. What do you see as the top opportunities for customers who are thinking about getting into this space but maybe don't really understand it as much? What do you think are the big opportunities they have?
There are lots. For example, if you look at the way the business have grown right now, we have concentrated most into the process level of it. What we are doing over here is that taking the robots out of the human and making them to work more of decision making. People, when they keep on clicking every time, it doesn't make them happy about it,
they
don't learn anything about it. So why don't we give that bot work to be done by a bot and the human get into more of decision making? So if you look at an opportunity area, I will suggest if somebody is trying to start on the RPA side, go slow, go small. There are a lot of processes that we can do. You can do on the employee side, you can do on the compliance side, you can do in the HR processes, you can do on the internal finances. You can also look into the customer onboarding, which is again one of the business areas. Believe me, your customers will love it when you onboard them in a fraction of seconds compared to a couple of days now.
Yeah, absolutely. And then if you look at where this is going and kind of the future, I mean, what do you see as, you know, there's been RPA, you're obviously involved in many other areas beyond RPA. Where do you see the future of this going in terms of the intelligent automation?
So future of RPA is definitely bright. That's a one word which I can say. But to explain it, the future is going to be more of analytics, more of the AI side.
Okay.
But to get into the AI side, the basics has to be strong, and that can be done by the RPA. Mm-hmm. You cannot run an artificial intelligence engine when you humans are working in the back end, because you cannot speed up for the consumption of the AI engine. So to make the AI engine run, you need to make sure that everything else is running on an RPA, which means that we are doing faster, better, cheaper. We are making sure that the quality has never been hampered. So that means that your AI engine is going to be 100% perfect if the base is definitely on an RPA base.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's really key. So there's a really strong linkage. We're seeing that as well. It's really about moving away from getting the data to what can you do with the data? What does it tell you, and being able to take business actions around that?
True. So what we have done, I mean, what I've seen in the industry at the time being is that the basic of business processes are getting automated. The next step we'll be looking into is probably the intelligent part of it, where we will be able to read documents, we'll be able to looking into the handwritings, and we will be able to learn from that, extract data, and then process it.
Right. Okay.
So that's something that we are already doing at majority of the telecom clients, and the industry have also adopted pretty well to that. And the next is definitely going to be how can we make an autonomous side of the RPA. Probably we'll call that as an RPA 3.0 or kind of thing, where it can read, execute, understand, and take decisions too.
Absolutely. And what do you think about with 5G? What do you see as the opportunity, really, as we partner looking at 5G?
So 5G is probably the next big thing which is going to change the way telecom works right now. There could be new players which will be coming in. There will be new processes which will be coming in. There will be new ways of doing business, right? The existing infrastructure has become obsolete. The existing process will definitely become obsolete, right? The business areas, when changing, you need more efficient, more faster people. And obviously, a digital worker is going to be much more efficient than a human worker.
Yeah.
So that's where we are seeing a lot of traction going on with all major telecom players globally. When they're looking into 5G ready, you need to make sure that your basic workforce is ready for the 5G implementations.
I like that, 5G ready, because you know we know it's going to be an implementation over time. There'll be the 4G, 5G interaction, but now is the time to really streamline and get ready. Well, thank you so much, Julen. It's just been a pleasure.
Appreciate it.
Always great to team up with you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. It's always great working with Automation Anywhere. You guys have been doing a fantastic job. We're looking
Absolutely.
Forward. Thanks.
Thank you.